Okay, here we are. We are on episode 3 of Breath of the Wild, and we are going straight into it. No title screen today. We're just going right into it. We're gonna get right into it.
Imposter. Canon's the imposter. What a canon. Among Us memes, man. So fun. Okay, where? It's over here, right? It's like on the. Yeah, okay. It's on this side. Hey, there's that cliff where it, like, rained a whole bunch. There's the desert. Oh, dude. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Riff, those guys, eh? Link, no. Oh. All right. I mean, that works. I didn't even need to die for that. I didn't even need to die. The heck, man? Okay, yeah, we'll finish this, we'll get the thing, and then, where'd I get the steak from? Oh, I must have taken it off the guy. It's gonna be like, where did I get a steak from? Oh, man. Where did you get a steak from? Ding. Enter in the code. That's gonna remain empty for for like the longest time. Because a DLC dungeon sucks so bad. To walk off the side and die again. Oh, well, I mean, putting it there works too. Not what I wanted to do, but it works, I guess. Anyway. We got the thing, boys. Sick, epic.
Ho!
That tower thing. It's literally down there. I just have to walk over there. Yeah, okay. Can you see that? Oh, I can't. My cold resistance is done. Well, don't need it. I literally just cranked that out in like a second. Oh, do you see him? Do you see him over there? Do you see him hanging? Okay, I know you're cold. I literally said don't fall off the edge and I fell off the edge. I could just, you know what? I could have teleported. Why didn't I teleport it? Alright, we're climbing down! I don't even know if I'm gonna continue playing this game. Like, controller drift is such a problem. I can't afford to get new ones. Whatever, who cares? Okay, please climb down. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. I'm so good. I'm so good. Dude. No! No! I'm not good. I'm silly horrendous at this game. I guess we're climbing. Alright, well. I mean, I guess we're just walking. Dude, am I gonna make this? I don't know. Yeah, I'm not. Alright. I'm teleporting. Forget it. I'm teleporting. Look at him crouch. Yeah, it's waiting on the wall. Just waiting for my teleport to kick in. No biggie. No biggie. Wait for my teleport to kick in. Okay, let's go. I know that I'm dying. This noise. This one was never here before. Like, I don't ever remember. I hit a tree. Can I just do a normal backflip? Oh. Why can't I do a normal backflip? They robbed me of this. Why can't I just do normal backflips, like, no tomorrow? I just wanna be a cool guy. I should eat some. Alright, there you go. Jeez. It's the lady. I gotta climb that all the way up there. There's a ladder just hanging out here. Dude, I've played 120 hours this game. And I've literally always just climbed up the side over there. There's a man hanging out down there. Dude. You're telling me. That this entire time, I could've just gone up the ladder instead of climbing up? I'm angry. Okay, I guess we're gonna watch this cutscene. Alright.
Well done, young one.
Thank you.
Now then, the time has come to show you who I truly am.
Oh, okay.
I was King Rome Bosphoramus Hyrule.
Epic.
I was the last leader of Hyrule. A kingdom which no longer exists. The great calamity was merciless. It devastated everything in its path. Lo, a century ago, it was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time, here I have remained in spirit form. I did not think it wise to overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile. So rather than that, I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think you are now ready. Ready to hear what happened 100 years ago. To know Calamity Ganon's true form, one must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror you see now. Stories of Ganon were passed from generation to generation in the form of legends and fairy tales.
Pig.
But there was also a prophecy. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear, and the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land. It wasn't long before we discovered several ancient relics made by the hands of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts, were giant machines piloted by warriors. We also found the Guardians, an army of mechanical soldiers who fought autonomously. This coincided with ancient legends oft repeated throughout our land. We also learned of a princess with a sacred power, and her appointed knight, chosen by the sword that seals the darkness. It was they who sealed Ganon away using the power of these ancient relics.
That's us, man, that's Link.
100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit a sacred power, and a skilled knight at her side. It was clear that we must follow our ancestors' path. We selected 4 skilled individuals from across Hyrule and tasked them with the duty of piloting the divine beasts.
Vali!
With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions, a name that would solidify their unique bond. The princess, her appointed knight, and the rest of the champions were on the brink of sealing away Ganon. But nay. Ganon was cunning, and he responded with a plan beyond our imagining. He appeared from deep below Hyrule Castle, seized control of the Guardians and the Divine Beasts, and turned them against us. The champions lost their lives, those residing in the castle as well. The appointed knight, gravely wounded, collapsed while defending the princess. And thus, the kingdom of Hyrule was devastated absolutely by Calamity Ganon. However, the princess survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final hope. The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
Yep.
That princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda. And the courageous knight who protected her right up to the very end. That knight was none other than you, Link.
Me?
You fought valiantly when your fate took an unfortunate turn. And then, you were taken to the Shrine of Resurrection. Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself. Even now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within Hyrule Castle, she calls out for your help. However, my daughter's power will soon be exhausted. Once that happens, Ganon will freely regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom, I have no right to ask this of you, Link. But I am powerless here. You must save her, my daughter.
Okay.
And do whatever it takes to annihilate Ganon.
Okay. We'll do it.
Somehow, Ganon has maintained control over all 4 divine beasts, as well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point.
I mean, I totally could, but it's gonna be, like,
I suggest
bad.
That you make your way east out to one of the villages in the
wilderness.
I've
never actually tried that.
Follow the road out to Kakariko Village. There you will find the Elder Impa. She will tell you more about the path that lies ahead. Consult the map on your Sheikah slate for the precise location of Kakariko Village. Make your way past the twin summits of the dueling peaks. From there, follow the road as it proceeds north.
There's two shrines up there. Alright. And, we're out of the, Great Plateau. We're out. Celebrate. Yes, I know. Goodbye. See you later. See you. Okay. Destroy Ganon. I mean, I could just go straight there if I wanted to, but then why would I want to do that? Hey, we're on our way. Hey. I had no arrows. Well, you know what? I think this is a good place to end the episode today. Yeah. We're gonna end the episode here. I'm probably gonna split this episode into two. So that, you know, I have something to post next week instead of, you know, not having to. Right? Anyway. Let's save the game. Okay. See y'all's next episode. Okie dokie.